Right, it's day 32, grade 12 applied. There's the announcements. There we go. What did we do here? Oh, let's flip page. Earth Day tomorrow, we got some pickup. Wear jeans, dress accordingly. Tickets to the first 120 folks for Goldeye Games. Next slide. Okay, let's start with our warm-up. Alright, so hopefully you do this stuff. Now, technically, this isn't really this grade, but you really got to know how to do this stuff, right? And it's a good use of your calculator, too. Right? I mean, you use these skills a lot. So knowing how to solve algebra is kind of a nice warm-up thing. So take away 2 off both sides. My goodness, there. So you divide by 3. There, the answer is 5/3. All right, 5/3. People, we got to know how to do this. I mean, this isn't even grade 12, but it's a lot of people still got to practice this once a week, so there's nothing wrong with doing this. Practicing this once a week is kind of important, especially if your nephew asks you in a couple of months, you'll go, Auntie, I know that you did grade 12. Can you help me with my algebra? Turns out there's another way you could have done it. You could have guessed. Guessing works quite nice. We've discussed different ways of solving problems. Right. In fact, we're supposed to teach you different ways of solving. Another way is just do a table. So, I like, a table's a good way to keep track of your guesses. So let's do some guessing. Guess and check. So let's guess that the answer's 3. So let's see, 3 nothings plus 2, is that equal to 7? No. Let's guess that 3, let's pretend x is 3. Let's guess for 3. 3 threes, 3 threes plus 2, is that 7? No, it's 11. So it's close, though. How about if we guess that, I don't know, how about 2? What's 3 2's plus 2? 3 2's plus, hey, that's 8. Hey, that's pretty close. Wow. So it's not too far off. So, I mean, yeah, if you just want to be close, you could say, the answer's around 2. Good enough, right? Now you could just play a little bit of high-low, right? Obviously, 1 is going to be too low because it's 5. So you know the answer's somewhere in between 1 and 2. So you could try 1.5. You could just play high-low like they do on Price is Right, 1.5. 3 1.5s is, let's see, 3 buck and a half is 4 and a half plus 2 is 6 and a half. Well, that's 4 and a half plus 2 is, that's almost 7. It's really 6 and a half, so it's close, right? So it's really 6 and a half, 6.5. So you might be happy with that. You could say, that's the answer, 1.5, right? I mean, that would be wrong, technically, but at least it's close. So, guessing and checking and making tables is another way to do it. How about counting pickles? All right, let's do some pickle jars here. This is my favorite way to do it, because then you don't need numbers. So just draw a picture of what you're trying to do. Here's 3 unknown amounts, plus 2 pickles is 7 pickles. And there's the, let's give it a name. X is the unknown amount. It's a little easier to do that, although we didn't really need these if you're just drawing pictures. All right, so those 2 pickles weren't in any jars, were they? So clearly we'll cancel away 2 pickles on that side. So that means the 3 jars must have had 5 pickles. So how would you share 5 pickles amongst 3 jars? Well, let's see, I'd put 1 pickle in each jar. Sure, that's good enough. Now how am I, so I got 2 pickles left over. Well, I'm going to have to break them into 3s. So let's see. I broke them into 3s because then I can put them into 3 jars. So 2 parts out of each 3 would go into each jar. So that's the same as saying 1 2/3. So I take 1 whole pickle and then 1 2/3 of another pickle. So each jar gets 1 2/3 and 1 2/3 and 1 2/3. Because 1 2/3 and 1 2/3 and 1 2/3 would give 5. So 1 2/3 and 1 2/3 and 1 2/3 and 2 would give 7. It works. 1 2/3 works. Alright, so that's kind of crazy. Let's try 3/4 on x plus 1 equals 4/5. I'll show you the complicated way on the left and then the easy way on the right. So hopefully none of this is new to you. So let's see. I like taking away 3/4 away from 4/5. If you want to take that away, and it doesn't matter to me. You can't screw up algebra. It's impossible. Seriously. All right, as long as you do the same thing to both sides. So I'm taking away 3/4 x on the one side. Now here's where the fun comes. What's 4/5 of an x take away 3/4 of an x? So let's do a little side calculation here. What's 4/5 take away 3/4? I think you'll find that it's, 16/20 minus 5. It's 1/20. So it turns out the answer is 1/20. So 4/5 of an x take away 3/4 of an x would be 1/20 of an x. So if 1/20 of a jar of pickles, see, if I broke this pickle in this pickle jar into 20 layers, if I had 20 layers in there and there was one pickle in each layer, how many pickles would I have? So if a 20th of a jar had one pickle, wouldn't that mean that there was 20 pickles in a full jar? Let's just do the algebra. Cancel out. Boom. There you go. The answer is 20. All right. Now, that was kind of complicated. You had to know what 4/5 take away 3/4 was. If you really, really hate fractions, get rid of them at the get-go. Get rid of them right at the start. Look at this. Notice the common denominator is 20, because 4 and 1 and 5, they make 20. So if you multiply both sides by 20, it's one of the tools, it's the only tool you use in math, is the same thing to both sides. So you end up with 20 times 3 over 4 plus 20 when you do this fact, this multiplying. And you end up with 80 divided by 5 times x. I think you'll find this is really just 15x's plus 20 equals 16x's. Oh, that's easy now, eh? Take away 15. Look, no more denominators. Woohoo. So you really end up with x equals 20. Is that any easier? Well, I suppose. So what you did was you got rid of the denominators here at the beginning instead of getting rid of the denominators at the end here. Some people like to do it this way better, by multiplying by the lowest common multiple. Anyway, or you could have solved it by graphing it. So you could have gone, bing, put this in the graphing calculator, drawn it, and found out where they intersected. That works too. So you could draw it on a piece of paper like this. You could see where they crossed if you had some paper. Not many of us walk around with paper. Not many of us walk around with a graphing calculator either. But at least the paper would give you a rough idea of the answer. You know it's somewhere up there. Put it on the graphing calculator, right? Second trace number 5 intersect, boom, boom, boom. It tells you there's the answer right there at 20, 16. So there, how many ways did we solve that? Lots of ways. There's more than one way to solve a problem. All right, let's solve this one. 4 times the sine of the angle plus 1 is equal to 3. So we'll, here's the angle, and we'll plot the sinusoidal curve along here. So here's what it looks like. Notice it's going to bounce around 1. Because that's the median. It's going to go 4 above and 4 below. 4 above and 4 below. It's going to look like that. Going to look like that. And when does it equal there? And I said just to keep your answers in between 0 and 2 pi. So I just want to keep your answers in that region there. Don't go telling me that one and 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 that one. I don't care about. I just want the first, around the first cycle. Just tell me the answers around the first cycle between 0 and 360 degrees. I don't care about all the other ones. Now notice that I'm asking you in radians, because otherwise I wouldn't have asked you for that. So there's your answer in radians for the first one, 0.52 radians. And where's the answer for the second one? The answer for the second one is at 2.62 radians. There you go. There's two answers. And of course, 0.52 radians is, remember how one radian is about 60 degrees? So this is trying to tell you that it's pretty much 30 degrees, isn't it? Well, in fact, it's exactly 30 degrees. And this one's trying to tell you that it's, well, 200, and you could turn that into degrees if you wanted, but I know that it's 150 degrees, right? Turns out that it's 150 exactly, funny enough, all right? So, next slide. And, of course, here's how you would do it with algebra. Now, you guys don't learn algebra for trigonometry. All you have to do is graph it. But here's how you would do it. If you know how to solve this, 4x plus 1 equals 3. Take away 1, divide by 4. If you know how to do this, like in grade 9, then you know how to do this. It's the exact same thing, just one extra step when you unsign at the end. All right, so you're going to take away 1, both sides. Boom, boom. Let's do the algebra. There, the 1's gone on the left side. All right, let's sneak this out. It's accelerator. All right, here we go. So you end up with 4 times the sine of the angle is 2. Divide both sides by 4. Turns out the sine of the angle is 1/2. What angle has a sine of 1/2? You put that in the plastic brain. The plastic brain will tell you that it's, boom, 0.5235. right? It's going to tell you that it's 0.52 radians, right? Which is pretty much what we said back there, wasn't it? 0.52 radians. Remember when we did that? 0.52 radians. Right, so the plastic brain tells you that. Now, the only problem with the plastic brain, of course, is the plastic brain doesn't understand that you're on a circle. The plastic brain only understands triangles. It doesn't know that you're actually on a circle or on a wave. So it only gives you the one answer. You have to be smart enough to realize that there's other answers. So you could look like this. You could say, well, the sine, remember, is the up and down. Remember how the sine is your up and down on the unit circle? So you know that you're halfway up the circle there, but notice you're also halfway up the circle there. Right? You're also halfway up the circle on this quadrant over on this side. So, of course, that's a 30-degree angle. Oh, I meant pi divided by 6, didn't I? So that's a pi divided by 6 radian angle there. And that's a pi divided by 6 angle over there. So don't forget, we always measure our angles from here to here. So you'd say that this was really pi divided by 6 short of pi. So this would really be a 5 pi divided by 6 angle, believe it or not. All right, so there's how it would work. It's really 150, for goodness sake. All right, so if you don't like that, just go back to drawing it like this and letting the plastic brain tell you the answer. But it turns out there is a way to solve this using algebra. For sinusoidal equations, it's called trigonometry. If you don't like this, just do it this way. Just make sure you know how to graph the curve and graph the line that it equals and then find where they intersect. All right, that will tell you all the answers you want. Let's do this one. Let's do something growing. So here's an example. I said that you got something growing. You got 100 marbles or 100 bunnies, maybe. And they're growing at 50% per year. So that's a 1.5 growth rate, right? They keep the mummy stays alive and she gets 50% growth rate. And so everything gets multiplied by 1.5 raised to the T. So that happens, T is your years, right? So, or whatever it is. I didn't tell you what this was, right? It's just the formula, right? And you know it looks like this, so whether it's bunnies or mold or money or who cares, it could be anything that grows. So graph it. So there's sort of what it looks like on the back of a cigarette pack. It's going to start like this, and it's going to grow. You know what looks like that, for goodness sake. And I'm asking you, when does it get to 375? Well, let's graph it. Let's put it in the calculator. Boom. So you put that in the calculator. So you put the 375 in the calculator, boom, and there's the equation. There's the equation growing right there. It's growing, it's growing. When does it get to 375? Come on, when does it get? Oh, right there. So you calculate, when does it get to 375? The spider says, doing number 2 trace. So second trace, number 5 intersect, boom, boom, boom. And it'll tell you that at 3.259, pretty much 3.26, then it equals... So at 3.26 right here, so a T of 3.26, 1, 2, 3 in a bit, it would grow to 375. All right, let's do some converting. 4 feet squared. Oh, see, I had it wrong there. It's a good thing I was checking the units. So I hope you know that 3.28 feet is 1 meter, give or take a... Right. I think it's 3.2804. Right, so I'm off by 4 ten-thousandths. All right, but the secret here is you got to square this. You got to do this twice because you want meters squared and you want to get rid of feet squared. Feet squared cancel feet squared. So you had to apply this 3.28 twice to the both edges, the length edge and the width edge. There's the answer. All right, cc's to liters. All right, so. Yeah, this would probably be the engine size of an F-150 Ford truck. So 3,250 milliliters is the same as 3.25 liters. I hope you can do that in your head, because that's why we invented decimals, so you could just move a decimal point. All right, 4 feet 5 inches. You'll need this for your project, for those doing the design and measurement project for their unit H. All right, so 1 inch is the same as 2.54 centimeters. 1 meter is the same as 3.258 feet. You got a bunch of choices there. 1 foot is the same as 12 inches. Let's use some of these to figure this out. Well, 4 feet. Let's convert everything into inches. Why are you going to mix apples and oranges? And what? It's feet and inches. Convert everything into one thing. How about just inches? Right? Convert it into the smallest unit, 53 inches. Right? Now you're going to convert the inches into centimeters. So I know that 2.5 of those things is the same as one of those things, because that's what this says, is. So, you know, it's a multiply problem, because guess what? A centimeter's smaller than an inch, so you're going to need more of them. So you know it's got to be a bigger number than the number of inches. And there you go. Turns out that you get 134.62 centimeters. Move the decimal two places, bing, bing, 1.3462 meters. And I would just round it to 1.35. I don't think anybody measures things to the nearest hundredth of a centimeter. That'd be a tenth of a millimeter. I mean, that's... even a flea is only a millimeter high. All right, so you get the rest of the class to work on your project and or your practice exam. There was your research project. I notice nobody actually went for the game or anything from what I can tell. There was lots of games you could have done. I offered up some ideas even before the break there. Could have been fun. I think most of us went for this project. It's due on the 24th. Due on the 24th. Right? So most of us went for this. You got to carpet your room and buy paint for the room. And don't paint the ceiling. Oh, that's a special kind of paint. All right, and there's the rubric for how we're marking it. It's due on Thursday. You got 3 more days to do this. You just add an hour and a half to do it. And then you get the practice exam. We've already started on some of this stuff. Practice exam. All right, there you go. Okay, so project is due 24th of April, Thursday. There we go. We've talked about this before. Okay, briefing complete.